It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. We'll be joined by Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. Today's topic is excuse. I assume this is from a professor or a teacher who said, hey, I want to calculate the percentage correct, but if the student was ill or not there or something like that, I don't want to include the score in the denominator. All right, so let's take a look at this. Of course, to get the totals, that's easy. Just hit Alt equals, and it will add the sum function there. But here's where the hard part comes in. We need to figure out the denominator, what we're going to divide by. And I'm just going to come down here and build this formula. Actually, we'll do it out here. Equal, I'm going to use SUMPRODUCT. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of the values up there in our scores. I'm going to hit F4 to lock that down. And multiply that by the results of an if or is number. Okay, now, is number is going to return a bunch of trues and falses. I need to convert those trues and falses into ones and zeros. So I'm going to do the minus minus trick. Is number. Hit tab there and check to see if these scores over here are numeric. All right, so we'll close the is number, close the sum product. And you see that here it's adding up the 10 and the 15 because the person was ill there. So because that's not numeric, I'm getting a 0 from the is number multiplied by 5 is giving me 0. I'm going to copy this up. We should see that we get 30 for student A because they were there for all of the possible events. All right, so now that we have this formula, I'll copy that to the clipboard, Control C, and we do equal this value divided by Control V, and bam, 72%. And when we copy it up, 73.3 because they're 22 divided by 30. All right, so that's it, using SUMPRODUCT for the denominator. Mike, let's see what you have.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Hey, gotta love that is number SUMPRODUCT. I like that is number because when I hit Enter, I can come over here and it's asking the question, are any of these numbers, right? And if I could type anything, I could type the letter O, N, E for not here, or even, check this out, a blank, right? So anytime. Now, if you wanted to include this as a 0 because they got a 0, you'd have to type a 0. And then sure enough, 60% because 18 divided by 30. Now, let's assume in this situation, I like this one. I can't really improve on that because if you have it blank, right, and you don't want that one included, is number works. But let's try something slightly different. I'm going to assume that a blank here would mean they didn't take the test. And not until we actually type a word like ill or not here or whatever do we need to exclude this. All right, I need to total, so I'm going to click there and Alt equals, Control Enter, double click and send it down. Now for the denominator, I'm going to use SUMIF. SUMIF is great. Range, that's the range that has the criteria. In our case, we're just going to highlight this. And when we copy it down, it'll move as a relative cell reference. Comma, criteria. I'm going to say try not a double quote. Not is less than, greater than. Screen tips in the way. And then ILL. All right, so there's the criteria. Anytime it finds anything that's not ill, like these numbers, it will add them, comma, and the sum range. Now, this range right here is called range, and it actually determines the size of this. So if I highlight this or this, it doesn't matter. Now, let me just look at this again. This is a 3 columns, 1 row. So when I click here like this, just that first cell, it'll know that it's supposed to be 1 row, 3 columns. All right, and I'm going to hit F4, close parentheses, Control Enter, double click and send it down. So that one's working. Obviously, though, if I type something like that, then it's not going to work. So I'm going to try and amend this. Actually, I'll leave it like that. Come up here, and instead of not ill, I'm going to say not text. And the wildcard asterisk says any sequence of characters. So that means anytime we type any text, even a space from now on, it will register. So I'm going to double click and send this down. So now I can type that, a space, or even ill. Right? And so what I'm thinking here is if we leave it blank, which means we haven't entered any text, then we want to count all of these, right? Because they haven't turned in an absence slip or something. All right, so we can take this, copy, escape, edit mode, control V, and then I'm going to click right here, divided by, control enter, double click and send it down. So now, when this person turns in their note, I can type email or whatever it is there, and that will do it. All right, I'll throw it over to Mr. Excel.